And now there is a bunch of people who are here because they feel something about the topics that are being shared today. So I'm really looking forward to catching up after what I share today. Okay. Can we begin? Or you can go to the video. I'm Nishi. She has given a very sweet and a brief introduction of me. I'll directly jump in. Going back to my childhood and my school days, we were talking about schools, I had a couple of social-emotional learning issues. I had a very difficult and a rough conversation and relationship at home, and obviously very low levels of self-esteem. I mean, I was absolutely opposite of what and how I am today. I went through all of that till I got into grade 11 in Ferguson, and then slowly I started thinking that I should read more about this because people like me do need help and do need somebody to hear us out, and rather to help us learn techniques to deal with this everyday anxiety and stress, because it's really difficult, believe me. So I started reading a couple of books on mental health. My grandmother had a few of them. I started reading those. I picked up psychology in my 11th and 12th and undergrad. I also studied psychology, soft skills even in my master's, and pursued a diploma in counseling after that as well. And basically decided that this is something that I wanted to spend my life in, working in, and creating a base which probably I missed out on when I was in school, and ensure that students today whom I deal with no longer go through this kind of anxiety in their everyday life. So here I am working at IT schools, using all my skills at a whole school level for all the students. But what I really want to talk about in the next few minutes is I want to share and these experiences and illustrate it through one specific student story whom I have worked with really closely in the past 2.5 years. Moving on to this slide, meet Hamid. Let's rewind to 2015. Hamid, a grade 8 student, extremely aggressive, very defiant, very complex in his behaviors. He's very worrying levels of verbal and physical abuse actually in the school, and he started to be as a perceived threat to the other students just within 5 months of entering the school. So he joined in June 2015, and by October 2015, literally everybody, teachers and students both, had started feeling afraid of him. He was the dada of the school and has started ganging up with a few students who also wanted to show their dominance and aggression, and they casually threatened the other students in the school. So from running away out of the school in anger, spitting in the class, hitting somebody with a chair, to getting addicted to a few drugs, being in a very bad company, getting kicked out of the home for a few weeks, Hamid had experienced it all. His parents had given up hope on him, and he had given up hope on him as well, okay, now that I reflect back. So, consistent occurrences of these behaviors, from getting intoxicating substances to school, from ganging up over and over again, from being highly disrespectful towards and abusive towards teachers, peers, and also school property actually. Unfortunately, he ended up being on the verge of getting expelled from the school. Though he was a very smart and a sharp guy, but he sought pleasure in just disrespecting everybody else around him. I wanted to take 10 seconds and imagine how did this guy feel. Keep aside all those behaviors. Take 10 seconds. Fast forward. Today, 2.5 years into the school, you can see a bright and smiling face up on the screen. Hamid has significantly improved on his attendance. He sets his own academic goals for every single assessment, be it a weekly test, unit test, or an NY exam, or an NOPA exam. He works with all the teachers and the peers around him to seek help to ensure that he achieves those goals. He wisely chooses his friends now because he really wants to work on his academics. And above all of this, he has informal conversations with the students in the school to motivate them earn and support their families. So last year in June, when he really wanted to come back to school after he was suspended for a few weeks, I guess, we were having a small conversation and he shared that दीदी पिछले दो महीनों में मैंने एक चाय के डब्बे पे काम किया और तब मुझे समझ आया कि कितना डिफिकल्ट होता है पैसा कमाना एंड आई आस्क्ड हिम व्हाई वर यू वर्किंग बिकॉज़ ही वाज एब्सोल्युटली नॉट लाइक दैट फॉर द पास्ट टू इयर्स और ही सेड कि दीदी कोई ऑप्शन नहीं था मुझे घर से बाहर निकाला था तो मुझे खाने के लिए पैसे कमाने पड़ रहे थे तो आई स्टार्टेड वर्किंग लाइक ओके हाउ वाज इट हाउ वाज द एक्सपीरियंस ही सेड दीदी एक दिन मैं गया और जो कस्टमर आए थे उन्होंने बहुत ही गुस्से से मेरे साथ बात की और मेरा दिल दिमाग घूम गया और मैंने भी उनके ऊपर चिल्लाया जैसा मैं करता हूँ स्कूल में सो ओके व्हाट हैपेंड व्हाट डिड यू एक्सपीरियंस मुझे निकाल दिया तो अगले दो दिन के लिए मुझे खाना नहीं मिला क्योंकि दो दिन मेरे पास पैसे नहीं थे तो आई स्लेप्ट ऑन द स्ट्रीट एंड आई अगेन वेंट बैक आई अपोलोजाइज एंड देन ही टुक मी बैक बिकॉज चाहे उनको भी चाहिए था कि मैं वहाँ काम करूँ फेयर रीजन सेपरेटली ही देन शेयर दैट दीदी तब मुझे समझ आया कि अगर मुझे इज्जत पानी है तो मुझे इज्जत देनी पड़ेगी और जो मुझे आती नहीं है तो आई रियली वॉन्ट दिस एजुकेशन आई वॉन्ट टू बी इन द स्कूल जहाँ पर मुझे आप जैसे टीचर्स सिखाए कि कैसे रिस्पेक्ट देते हैं या कैसे बात करते हैं कैसे सेटिंग में जहाँ पर कोई वैल्यू नहीं है अगर तुम्हारे पास एजुकेशन और अच्छे सब शब्द नहीं है So I really want to come back. I really want to get the complete my education. I want to earn, but with respect. And मुझे इज्जत की ज़िंदगी जीनी है, like quote unquote. Take 10 seconds and think what was this transformation from a very helpless story to a very empowering story in these 2 years. Was there magic? Maybe, but not just by one professional mental health counselor, but by all the teachers, by all the advisors, and a few students who really felt strongly to help me come out of this. So it was a owned transformation by every single member in this group who felt strongly that no, this cannot come in the way of one student getting out of the system. So. I really want to talk about the 4 hows that I teach schools engage in to strengthen this social emotional program. Because this was one key factor that really transformed me from where he was to where he is today. Of course, I won't be able to build any skills in the next 3-4 minutes, but I'm very happy to catch up personally if anybody wants to know what we do in depth after this. So, these are the 4 things. First is the counseling support that I would want to talk about. So we have one counselor in every school who works very dedicatedly and consistently with the students, both on remediation and counseling, special counseling support. Hamid and I work together very consistently for about a year and a half, excluding his missing out of the school and the other times where he wasn't in a mental state to go through any kind of sessions. So consistently for a year and a half and which got this transformation to place. Advisory support, which we actually thought was one of the strongest programs to affect all the students very, very positively. So we have a ratio of about 15 students to one advisor who spend an informal time every 2 hours in the week and they basically create a space for themselves where they can very candidly and very courageously share about their own personal concerns and also actively listen to what the others are sharing. Also suggest a few solutions, potential solutions or at least perspectives to what those personal concerns are and basically make them feel belong, right? So that's the key. Because they don't feel belonged, they hesitate to share anything that comes in their way, and they basically don't see a way out of where they are stuck. As I mentioned in my story, like I did want help, but I didn't know where that channel was. So this is sort of that space and that channel where the students can find help from each other and not just rely on one teacher or one advisor. So boy in their advisory circle of 14 girls. And obviously, initially, he was very upset with me because I had formed those groups. And we had a debate initially about why did I put him in that group when he knew there were 14 other girls. And what was he doing there amongst all those 14 girls. But we thought of staying with that strategy, and I told him that let's figure out what happens. So a few months down the line, he was in Tanvi's advisory. Once he walked up, and also Tanvi shared with Tanvi after that, he was literally in tears in one of the advisory sessions because he heard very powerful but very challenging story of his friend. And he knew this friend for about 5 to 6 years till now, but he wasn't aware at all of what she's going through if he actually heard it that as an advisory speech. Now the point is not that he was in tears. The point is that one boy who hated being with all those 14 girls, thinking that all my other male friends are having fun because they are in that homogenous group, he actually started feeling responsible to start helping his other friends who have similar issues. Moving on to our school design. So we spend 65% of our instructional time in core academics and spend 35% of our time in engaging in PE, career awareness programs, choice reading, there is the apprentice project. So basically creating multiple avenues where a student can shine and showcase his or her potential, which is not specifically related to academics. Right? So here, yes, it is a holistic program design that we share out, but through this we also want to focus on building child's self-confidence and his self-esteem, right? Because it is very natural that those who shine academically naturally tend to participate more in these events, thinking that I'll be good at these as well. But then who are academically a little struggling, they tend to think that I won't be good at XYZ because I'm not good at ABC. Krishna, one of my 8th grade students, did not even utter one word at the beginning of last year when he started at RSM. And then 6 months into the school, now he participates in PE very actively, participates in all the poster presentations that happen in the class, and participates in the chess club that happens after school, and competes with the academically high potential friends that he has. And actually debates with them if they go wrong or they cheat. So that was a bonus for us. First he started speaking was an achievement. So these programs essentially push those students who feel that I might not be good at something, but then give them a chance to shine at that. And lastly, the foundation course, which is one of the highlights not only in the students' lives but also all the staff members. So the bottom 20%, academically bottom 20% students from all the feeder schools, writing schools, come to us for a 5, and they undergo a 5-week foundation course after they finish grade 7 and before they go to grade 8, so essentially April and May. They have had a very, very difficult school life till now. They're failing at multiple levels into various reasons. So, obviously, the kind of parent investment also that comes along with it, the kind of their investment in academics and participating in all these other events is also quite questionable. So foundation course, yes, it does aim at bridging the academic gap and basically creating a very strong academic base for these students, but more so working on their self-confidence and self-esteem again, right? So that when they start in June, they feel equal with the others. They undergo a bunch of activities like drum circles, dance therapy circles, they celebrate a gratitude week, there are field visits, there are advisory circles, and all the conversations with all these students is essentially targeted to young adults. So we treat them as young adults, they pick up all the values and the skills as young adults, so basically when we start in June, they feel equal with the other classmates that join them. We've been doing this for the past couple of years, and obviously we are evolving and open to learning. But I want to share a quick 50-second story to make you see why are we doing this, right? So Varun Venkat, who's the owner of Tal Inc., who also conducted drum circles at the foundation for 2017. So he walked into one of the initial drum circle sessions with Neha, and he was observing. So a few students were aggressively drumming. Drumming was absolute fun for them. But there were five students who were aggressively drumming, and they were standing out from the rest of the students. So he was observing them particularly. And they did that. They basically continued it. So he got up walking on, because apparently it seemed that they were going to continue doing that for the rest of the drum circle class that day. And when he walked out, he candidly shared with Neha that they're not drumming. They're basically depicting how they are being treated at home. Do we know this? That if a child is facing such issues at home, will probably act out this way? We need to know it. But what's more important is this kind of a social emotional support will prove to be a key in changing all these negative or difficult behaviors into these kind of